Yeah, I'm Holyfield. I'm Holyfield.
Why the real deal? How did that come about?
Well, real deal came up, you know, at in Olympics, I got disqualified, and they started calling me Raw Deal. I said, no, I'm the real deal. Like that, I ain't want to be nothing negative. I ain't want my whole life be built upon something negative. So it didn't work. And what didn't work actually worked for me because I got the ABC contract. I got $1 million. Everybody else got a gold medal. I got a bronze medal and $1 million.
Today, if you win the gold, you get $40,000 and you get taxed on it.
Really?
So you're going home with 20, maybe less. Here in the United States. Other countries, like Azerbaijan, $10 million for the gold. Other countries appreciate the Olympics a little more.
It's not $10 million for the gold.
Azerbaijan.
No, it isn't. No.
You better do. You go back and watch your fights. And if you do, which is your favorite fight to go back and look at?
The Dwight Muhammad Kwawe fight is foremost the best one. That, you know, but don't mean I got more joy from it, but that was the best one. But you know, the Tyson fight is one that when I beat Tyson, that's when everybody started saying, you're the champ. You're the heavyweight champion. Because I beat him. Then nobody cared nothing about nobody else. They said, you beat him. And then what they said, and you didn't run from me either. You beat him. Like that. So they were, that's it. I after that, it's almost like it was easy to say, oh, I really don't have to fight.
Did you knew you always had the beating of him, though? Did you know that?
Well, my mama told me, she said, son, you can't wish good people away. It's the people who are good. You can't wish them away, son. And my mama said, okay, that'd be your toughest fight. But, son, you can't wish people like that way. You just got to start preparing. You know that he's tough, so you got all the time to prepare yourself for what's coming.
You know, no fighters are scared, but a lot of fighters are scared of Mike Tyson. When you went in the ring with him, why was your mentality different, or did you have kind of a little nervousness too going up against him?
I wasn't scared of no.
That was very nice.
I'm not. I'm telling you, you know, afraid when you don't do what you're supposed to do. That's what afraid really is. Mm. It's not by the butterfly I had when I was. When I was 8 years old, when I got in the ring, it felt the same way. Oh my goodness! But when I got 9, it's the same. It's keep the same feeling because you keep fighting better people. Mm. So you growing.
It's always there.
So you growing. So everybody asked me, sir, how in the world can you get in front of all these people and just look like this? And I grow to that. It wasn't overnight.
So that nervousness does go away because Floyd always says he's never nervous.
Some people. It's not. A lot of people call different things how they feel. My whole thing is that if when I get in the ring, my leg starts doing like this. I have to put all my weight on this leg to keep this leg from doing it. I know I'm not scared, but I do like this.
My leg
starts doing like this. But I get like this. So what people start doing, worrying about what somebody else think. So my mom was good and said, son, don't worry about what nobody else think. You do what you're supposed to do. Stop worrying about what somebody else thinks. You're going to really lose it trying to please everybody what they think it is. You know, do your very best. If they like it, fine. If they don't, fine.
What was it obviously in that series about Tyson where he turns up on ringside when your son's boxing?
Yeah.
It looked very touching that day. Was that an enjoyable experience for you?
Wait, that's the Tyson that I knew.
Yeah.
I realized Tyson and I, we were both on the losing squad trying to make the Olympic team.
Yeah.
And people forget that. Yeah. I said, this guy nice just like everybody else. Only thing that he wanted to be, he